It is a glitzy beginning for the sport of gymnastics in the year 2000. We're in the city of Las Vegas, Nevada, and from right where Barbara Streisand sung in the new millennium, we'll see the RCA Gymnastics Challenge here at the MGM Grand Garden Arena. This is the first of three events comprising the Visa American Cup Series, which will crown an American Cup champion in late February. There are eight men and eight women competing today, and the top three international gymnasts automatically qualify for that American Cup final. The top American female goes too. Now, the top American male qualifies as well, but the status of Blaine Wilson recovering from shoulder surgery complicates things, and we'll be explaining that more later. I'm Al Troutwig, along with Tim Daggett and Elfie Schlegel. We'll hear from Beth Ruyak later. The competition has already been underway, and so far in the vault, what has been a highlight for you guys?
Well, the highlight for me was definitely Elena Prokhorova of Russia. Although she had some short landings in this event, you clearly saw her powerful style of vaulting, one of the top vaulters in the world. She had some fairly high start values in her difficulty, but again, didn't throw the most difficult vault that she performed at the World Championship. She's saving that for later on in the year.
Prokhorova gets a 9.30. That puts her in front after the first women's rotation. Tasha Schweikert, more on her story later, but she is from Las Vegas. This is her hometown, and she's tied with Amy Chow, and being the top American here today is a big deal. Now we get to the men's story, and so far we've seen them on floor exercise and pommel horse, and what's done it for you so far?
Well, Brett McClure, right out of the box, his first really big meet of this nature. His first pass, great job. Acted like a veteran on this, could have taken a step out of bounds, really stayed calm. But check this out from Bondarenko. This sequence that he does on the floor exercise, it's like running a marathon. You have to be exhausted. If you're human, you have to be exhausted. For him, it's no problem at all.
Bondarenko told us when he first saw the skyline of Las Vegas, it was shocking. But it's not shocking to see him in the lead, followed by Brett McClure and Stephen McCain, with Jay Thornton coming up behind them. This is the RCA Gymnastics Challenge, and we're just getting started. Gymnastic fans have come out in force here at the MGM Grand Arena as we watch the RCA Gymnastics Challenge, the first in the Visa American Cup Series. Hi, everybody. I'm Al Troutwig. Well, the United States in a bottom-line world has not brought home a single medal in the last two World Championships. That doesn't make USA Gymnastics very happy. To effect a change, at least on the women's side, they have brought back coaching guru Bella Karolyi to oversee all of the coaching for the women as they approach Sydney and the Olympic Games. Tim Daggett will sit down and talk to Bella a little bit later in our coverage today. As for the overall gymnastic picture, well, 8 months to the day from now, the United States will send out six men and six women to compete in the Olympic Games. Who will they be? Well, those spots are up for grabs, and every competition between now and the beginning of the Olympics is critical for all the gymnasts to make every good impression that they can. So that's the kind of pressure they're competing under here today. For a little bit more of an international flavor, let's go across the floor to Tim Daggett. Tim?
Well, on the men's side, it's a good field, and it's led by Alexei Bondarenko. He's got the best credentials out on the floor today. Many people thought he would contend to win a world championship all-around medal last year in China. He did not even come close. I tell you, I will never forget the scene with him with his head buried in his hand after that competition. He told us he made a promise to himself that night that he would never let that happen again. Well, it's 2000, the Olympic year, and certainly the most important of his life. We'll see if he keeps that promise to himself. He is our leader. He's next on rings. It's one of his best events. Let's go on over on the floor to Elfie.
Americans will remember Amy Chow and her silver medal performance in Atlanta on the uneven bars, that along with her Olympic team gold medal. But you know, that was 4 years ago. Amy is staging a comeback. She's taken a year off college. I asked her, why is she doing this? She said, you know, something is missing in my life. Well, with all that talent and experience, Amy is sure to be a key contributor to this American team. She's right now tied for second, heading into her strongest apparatus.
And back across the floor we go to Alexei Bondarenko, who is the leader. And basically, Tim Daggett, if he doesn't win this competition, it would be a pretty big surprise, especially to him.
It's certainly what he is. Like we said, he is one of the major contenders in the world right now, all around wise, and certainly on this event as well. Great constructed routine, capitalizes on strength. That's a little bit high though. That's gonna get a deduction. But where he really shines is on the swinging elements. He'll show us a couple of them combined together, gets him just tons of bonus points right here. Now finish right in a handstand. Very, very tough competitor. Full twisting double laid out somersault.
He sticks it at the end.
Yeah, really.
Moscow and Russia's Alexei Bondarenko.
Really, the only problems in that routine was that one strength part was a little bit high. That's going to cost him at least a couple of tenths. Dismount was fantastic, but, you know, he kind of second-guessed himself a little bit here. Nice stretch body. You see that landing? And then what happens here? He kind of bends forward. That's one of those things, Al, that if the judge wants to take a deduction, they can.
The very soft-spoken leader of the RCA Gymnastics Challenge. We'll be back to Las Vegas, Nevada on NBC after this.
NBC's Sports World is brought to you by RCA, changing entertainment again. By Visa, the preferred card of the U.S. gymnastics team. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
Back at the RCA Gymnastics Challenge, Alexei Bondarenko says that little wool pink thread around his wrist helped him overcome some pain. Now, we've heard of magnets and copper. Now we've got little threads of wool. He's legitimately serious when he talks about it. And he got through the still rings with a score of 9.412. That should keep him in the lead. We shall see. And in a moment, we're going to get our first look at some of the Americans here at the RCA Gymnastics Challenge. Meanwhile, over on the uneven bars, we're going to see Marlia Gomez of Brazil. She had a disappointing 8.6 in her vault. That was the first time through for the women.
But Al, this will be her strongest apparatus. She's the reigning Brazilian national all-around champion. She's had a lot of international experience, including the recent world championships. Of course, Brazil finished 18th as a team, just missing by a few spots to send a team to the Sydney Olympics. This is some of her most difficult gymnastics right here in this combination.
Just a little bit of form here and there. Each time those legs bend a little bit or come apart, it's a deduction.
Tough dismount planned. Double front Arabian with a half out.
An amazing landing with the body position that she had, not finishing that twist. And
she has a Japanese coach, that's Yumi Sawasato. And we'll get her score in a moment. Right now we go back to the rings for the United States, Stephen McCain. Now here's the deal. You've got six spots. The USA Gymnastics is negotiating right now with the USOC to finalize the selection process. But basically what it comes down to is that three or four of the spots are going to come from the trials and the nationals. The other couple, two or three spots, will be selected by a committee that does not yet exist. Here's an athlete like Stephen McCain, who's got to basically try and impress everybody as often as he possibly can.
Exactly, and in key situations just like this right here. You see these inverted crosses, a little bit high, but better than we saw from Bondarenko earlier.
You know, Steve was getting antsy just training throughout the holidays. He said, I need to get out there and do some competition to assess my performance.
Wow, that, I tell you, that sequence right there, that's about as well as I've seen him do this. Very good routine for Steven so far.
rings are remaining still. Nice dismount, just that small hop on the landing.
But he's been consistent.
And I'll tell you, he has been one of the great talents that has come out of USA Gymnastics.
And the score is in from Arlia Gomez of Brazil, a 9.3, a significant improvement from her first score, an 8.6. And now the score for Stephen McCain, a 9.300 on the still rings. Jay Thornton now, and this is a guy who was right on the bubble. Top six go to the World Championships. He was number 7, the alternate, so he knows he's got to be better.
He certainly does, and it is everything to him, he said. When it turned 2000 at midnight, all he could think about was, this is going to be the best year of my life, and this is not the best ring routine of his life.
He's actually struggled in the first couple events so far.
Yeah, this is pretty much a blown routine at this point. He had to bend his knees in the middle of that element. That'll cost him, and he's really struggling here.
Jay started slowly, a 9.025 on the floor. And Pommel at a 9.15. No big time number coming here.
No, he will not see a 9 on this event. That's going to be a disappointment for him.
Well, you had two last minute additions, Brett McClure and Tasha Schweikert, a native of Las Vegas, and they're still to come as the RCA Gymnastics Challenge continues on NBC. Normally in the American Cup, there are two American men and two American women. This time, there are three, and there's a reason for that. To explain, we go to Beth Rujak. Beth?
Thanks, Al. Originally, two Ukrainian athletes were scheduled to be in this meet. There was a delay in getting their visa approved. By the time it was approved, they couldn't get a flight here in time. So two more Americans were called to come to the meet. Very excited, the call went out to the Olympic Training Center in Colorado, and Brett McClure quickly packed his bags. The other call went to Las Vegas, Tasha Schweikert, who just had to drive across town. She's coming up on bars, which is her favorite event, and she's performing tonight before the hometown crowd. Back to you, Al.
All right, Beth, and so far, the two last-minute substitutes have been doing very, very well. Meanwhile, on the still rings, Jay Thornton gets a score of 8.85, a little higher than maybe you thought.
Yeah, very surprising there.
So he's in his own little musical world. And now we'll see how Brett McClure handles being in second place after the first two rotations. You know, suddenly you're a last minute insertion, then you start thinking, maybe I could be the top American.
Well, it's amazing. I mean, this kid has really just burst onto the scene. He had such a tremendous competition at the championships last year. He finished third in the all round. Everybody in the arena, including Brett, was shocked. But he really is a tremendous talent. He faltered at the trials later on, but just needed a little bit more time. Now watch this coming up, so difficult. He'll do three of these in a row right here. I tell you, it may not look hard, but very, very difficult and gets a lot of bonus points.
Tim, you talked about him not making the World Championship team. He was really disappointed with that result, and he said he is positive that this season he's going to be in the top three.
I tell you though, he really acts like a veteran in a lot of ways. That landing, for example, he could have easily taken a small little hop, given a tenth away, but he took his time, he was relaxed. Very good job. Here's that crazy sequence. He does three of these double flips in a row. They're called Gutsogis and O'Neills, if you can believe it. Three of them in a row. That's six revolutions. I don't know about you, but I'm a little bit dizzy just watching it, Al.
Well, it's pretty ironic that the Ukrainians had that problem, considering this is the Visa American Cup Series. But they didn't get out. Brett McClure is in. And so far, he's made the most of his opportunity. Now we go to the other last-minute substitution. Tasha Schweikert, mom and dad in the building. And she has had a lot of cheering, no surprise. And after the first rotation, she was in third place, 9.175.
You know, I've been impressed with her mental attitude. I mean, she, talking to her in training, I was just casually saying, how do you feel about being here with all the big guns? And she said, oh, it's no problem, I'm ready for this. I welcome the challenge. This is experience that I need.
And here's what's on the line for Tasha. The most important international competition held every year in the United States is the American Cup. It comes in Orlando the last week of February. If Tasha Schweiker could somehow be the top American and qualify for that, that would be a major step and a big prestige moment for her.
No question about that. It would really just catapult her.
Nice release skill.
Along with Elfie, I'm very impressed with how calm she is in this environment.
Looking good, Tasha Schweiker. Shannon Warren, her dad. Not a lot of emotion, just seems like he's been here before, you know?
Yeah. First year as a senior competitor.
She was tied with Amy Chow in third and fourth spots, respectively.
I was impressed. I don't know about you, Tim, but this routine flowed from beginning to end. Nice handstand positions. This was a highlight right here. Look at how
beautiful
high she takes Hatikachev. Lots of extra swing there.
I tell you, you never know how an athlete who hasn't been in this situation is going to react for the first time. That's probably the best sign that her coaches could ever see. She's in the biggest meet of her life, and she goes out there and does everything that she can.
And the score for Brett McClure is a 9.262, so we'll evaluate his standing in a moment.
The highest I've ever scored.
As they announce it to the crowd here at the MGM Grand Arena. The score for Tasha Schweiker is a 9.175. And we'll wait to the end of the rotation to see how she stands. And we stick with the women now. This is Alona Poloskova of Belarus.
Well, she's been to a huge event before, including the Olympic Games in Atlanta, competed at the 99 World Championships where her team finished 12th and she was 35th herself. But you know what? This is an event that she fears. She fears the uneven bars.
Yeah, her coach said that she is just a little bit afraid of this event. She got into a bit of an argument with him. No, I'm not afraid, but
she actually did very few bar routines in practice, not quite sure what to expect here.
And this team from Belarus, one of the, obviously after the breakup of the Soviet Union, one of the republics that did quite well initially, but
wow.
That was beautiful. Absolutely beautiful
dismount.
Wow.
Nothing to be afraid of there.
Jeez.
She said she's known for her beautiful gymnastics, and there were some exquisite lines in that routine.
Yeah, she's a great gymnast, but like I was saying, Belarus has fallen off somewhat.
This is Eric Lopez about to mount the rings from Cuba, and this is a most significant year for the Cuban athletes. 84, they boycotted to support the Soviet Union. 88, they did the same thing to support North Korea. Then they had some financial problems. They also had times when there weren't any good gymnasts. And here, they've got one. He hasn't had a great day so far, but this is a day when Eric Lopez can probably admit to himself that he's going to bring back Cuba to the Olympic Games in gymnastics.
Yeah, and he could do more than just participate, I can tell you that. And you'll get a taste of it here on the Still Rings. He's a contender. He, very, very strong athlete. Tremendous positions.
You know, it's so ironic. He's been a three-time all-around champion at the Pan American Games, then goes to Worlds. Doesn't do great there, and not having a great start here at this competition.
Yeah, Elfie, he started with an 8.187, then a 9.412 on the pommel.
But he is a monster.
Straight across, too, Tim, you know?
Yeah. Has done very well at different times in his career, at different events, as Elfie said, not just Pan American, but World Championships as well. Necessary, but it's going to bring in a big number.
Alona Poloskova of Belarus also gets a very big number, the highest we've seen so far today, a 9.575. And another very big score, this time for Eric Lopez of Cuba, a 9.575, so we get those back-to-back. So after three rotations, the women are in mid-rotation. Alexei Bondarenko of Russia leads. Then in the battle to be the top American, Brett McClure, the last minute insertion into the lineup, is in second, followed very closely by Stephen McCain, also of the United States. But look what that score did for Eric Lopez. It moves him into fourth place here at the RCA Gymnastics Challenge. We still haven't seen a gymnast for the United States who some people think can make a lot of noise in Sydney. Morgan White when we come back. So the women continue on the uneven bars. We go back to Elena Prudanova. Gina.
Tim mentioned her string of fourth place finishes at the World Championships. Very frustrating. This was one of the events where she finished fourth, probably her weakest, I'd say. She's struggling a little bit throughout this routine. Hasn't had a lot of training time since the holidays.
But she is a fighter, I'll tell you. Her best quality is her toughness out on the floor. She's a competitor.
Want to feel?
Struggled a little bit throughout the routine. There were some form breaks with her legs, but this was an exciting dismount, full twisting, double back salto. This is what they do well, clean landings, just a really slight hop.
Had a disappointing vault. She didn't like it, a 9.3, but still she was the leader after the first rotation. Now at the vault, it's Stephen McCain. Right now in fourth place and trailing Brett McClure. Now, we have to explain the story. Blaine Wilson is the top American gymnast, plain and simple.
Wow. You know, this is Steve's vault, a double twisting Sukihara. He's done it for a while. I didn't see him warm it up at all.
He went about 2 feet to the left coming off the vault and almost landed off the mat.
Yeah, that's one of the reasons why I thought there was no way he was going to do his normal vault here. Throughout all of the training, he's been kind of snapping his feet down a little bit early. He goes around the side right from the beginning, and that causes him to travel. You see his feet kind of go sideways there, and he just drifts over. Of course, when you land outside of that box there, those white lines, that is a deduction in gymnastics.
So the top American, because of Blaine Wilson's status here today and in the second event of the Visa American Cup Series, the best score of these two would advance to the American Cup Final to allow Blaine Wilson a chance to go for a fourth straight American Cup. And that's if Blaine Wilson goes. If he does not go to the American Cup, the top American in both of these first two events here and in St. Petersburg, Florida, would advance to the American Cup. Back to Elena Prudanova as they announce her score here in Las Vegas. 9.5. That's a big score here today, and that should easily keep her in the lead. On the uneven bars, we go to Morgan White. 1999 was a breakthrough year for her. She went to the Pan Am Games in Winnipeg, Manitoba, and won the whole thing.
But Al, even with her performance at the Pan Ams and her performance at the World Championships, she doesn't consider herself a veteran by any means. She said she's extremely nervous for this first competition of the year.
Watch this coming up here. She'll do what's called a dorsal grip and then do an endo stalter right here. Very, very difficult. I've never seen another gymnast in the world do that, another female gymnast.
That's how you make a name for yourself, right?
Oh, definitely. Pushing the envelope. You know, oftentimes you don't really get rewarded as much as you should, but eventually it does chip away and it gives you a name.
She needs to put a whole lot of thought into this dismount. It's been giving him person problems.
Actually, that was pretty good for her.
Her coach, Mary Lee Tracy, likes it. Last year, Mary Lee coached Jenny Thompson to the American Cup win.
Pirouette was good and opening.
You know, Morgan was saying before the competition that on the bars, that's the one event that she tends to hold back on. She said that her best quality is her competitiveness as an athlete, but she wishes that she wouldn't hold back so much on the uneven bars.
She also says she's not really tight, and I tell you, watching her, she looks like she's one of the tightest, cleanest kids out on the floor.
Nice handstand lines.
Didn't start well, an 8.612 on the vault, but
She and Mary Lee Tracy have refocused and regrouped. And now they're announcing the score for Stephen McCain, a 9.1, as he tries to keep up with Brett McClure. Next vaulter, also from the United States, who's had a rough day, Jay Thornton. And we can't emphasize enough these chances to reaffirm your status on the American team or break in to be a factor, to somehow get on that six-member team to go to Sydney. All these scores, all these impressions that you make, they matter so much.
The style of ball we see from the women quite often. Yurchenko, laid out full twist. Jay's been doing that thing for a long time.
You know, Tim, that landing had to have hurt. He said that was the one event that really would kill his Achilles.
He's really been quite afraid, told me that he thinks that he could suffer a career-ending injury on this, and he says the landing on vault is what hurts the most. Doesn't look like that one hurt all that bad, but
absorbed it well.
Jay actually is capable of doing a double twist as well, but that Achilles has really hampered his training on this exercise.
And this is something that he practices, who knows, hundreds of times a week, and to be thinking that you could pop your Achilles at any moment, wow. And we're about to get the number for Morgan White as she tries to overcome an 8-6 start. And she's done that. She's back in the picture here in Las Vegas with a 9.5. And Mary Lee Tracy knows that every day is an emotional tug of war, little ups and downs and bumps.
See? Lessons to be learned in everything we do. You felt like giving up, didn't you? So did I. But I've been there too many times, Morgan, and I've watched. It's never over till you hit that last event.
9.137 is the score for Jay Thornton. He goes back to check in with Stephen McCain. One more American to go. And remember, he was the last-minute substitute when the Ukrainian team had visa problems and couldn't make it here to Nevada. And Brett McClure, coming into this rotation, was the number one American.
A sign, how bad do you want it, hangs in the gym. He says he thinks about it every day.
Well,
very nice ball. Good laid out position, small hop on the landing. It's going to definitely be enough to move him ahead of both of the Americans. The key to this vault is to keep your body as straight in the air as you can. Really not as good of a bounce off of the horse as I've seen Brett do in the past, but he's very clean, and that small hop on the landing, he's gonna take that one.
So we'll get Brett McClure's score in a moment. When we come back, we'll find out if Amy Chow can keep up with the women's last minute insertion into the lineup, Tasha Schweikert. Back in Las Vegas, you're looking at Brett McClure. He's writing himself a pretty good story. The men have reached halftime. They've completed three rotations, and he gets a 9.2 on the vault, and that keeps him in the number two spot, but also keeps him as the number one American here in the men's competition at the RCA Gymnastics Challenge.
Up next on the other bars.
After the first rotation, she was tied with Tasha Schweikert. Tasha Schweikert put up a 9.175. So that's Amy Chow's target right now.
That's a walk in the park for Amy Chow. This should be a real treat. One of the best uneven bar workers in the world. Very new element for Amy.
Beautiful combinations. You know, one of the things that Mark Young said she has struggled with is conditioning. Just hung on. He said it'll be a huge success for her to get through this entire routine. Wow.
Could you imagine how valuable she could be, having been through the Olympic battles under this guy, Bella Caroli's guidance? Could you imagine what she could do for a Morgan White and maybe a Vanessa Attler when Vanessa gets back healthy?
Well, that and the
there is no substitute for experience when you've been there and you've done it and you've come out on top.
Beautiful combinations. Look at the Stalder work. As Tim said, doing some of the best work in the world, connects into a release skill, into a second release skill. in her transition down to the low bar. Just beautiful combination. She's never stopped training since the Olympics. I think that's important to know.
Well, watch this. Look at how she like kind of reaches behind her head to grab the bar there.
She found it.
She's a very smart woman. She goes to Stanford, after all, wants to be a pediatrician, but right now she is a gymnast in a very big way. There with her coach, Mark Young.
I know.
And speaking of Mark Young, there he is living through every move of Amy's bar routine, and over his shoulder you can see Bella Crowley. Obviously, he is extremely interested in how Amy is going to perform in today's competition. Relief from Mark.
Back to the men and back to the vault and back to Eric Lopez of Cuba.
And we saw some power from Eric on still rings, and you'll see that same power. He will smash that horse, jump his body into the air, leave the horse and do 2.5 twists in a laid out position. This is just plain downright hard. Oh, wow.
Makes it look pretty easy.
You know, it's like I coach some kids and you try to get them to do this and it just never looks like that. Wow.
He started badly, but he's coming back after the third rotation. He was all the way up to fourth place. And remember, to these gymnasts, there's big time money available here today. If you win this event, this RCA Gymnastics Challenge, you get $10,000. To someone like an Eric Lopez, wow, that's like the lottery. Amy Chow gets a big score, 9.575. That breaks the tie with Tasha Schweikert for now and moves her up to second place behind Elena Prudanova.
9.637.
Eric Lopez gets the highest number today so far with a 9.637. He has come roaring back from a slow start. To the vault and Alexei Bondarenko.
Actually, whenever you do this, it is one of the most difficult things in gymnastics to land. It's a blind landing and your body actually turns over 3 times in the air. You're flying up vertically and you're traveling across the plane horizontally. It's a lot to get done and then somehow magically just land on your feet. Here we go. Oh, no way, no.
Wow,
that was amazing. Big, big mess up in his run.
Right from the start.
He adjusted his run halfway down, and there, on a vault like that, you need every ounce of power you can get.
Longtime Russian coach Leonid Arkayev, sort of stone-faced. They both know what just happened.
Yeah, so we'll be able to see this here. On the run, he just gets a little bit off. Right there, you kind of see him doesn't get anywhere near the block that he needs, and there was just no way. It travels off to the side and no bounce off the horse. You have to be completely on your game to make that thing.
Alexei Bondarenko is not going to love this score. It's a 9.175, but he had a big lead to play with, so right now he's in front of Brett McClure, the surprising American, by 28 hundredths of a point. Then it's Eric Lopez, who's vaulted all the way up to third place for Cuba. Then Stephen McCain and Jay Thornton. Remember, the top American today is very, very important. Now we switch over to the women's story. And the lead for Elena Prudanova has been maintained, but look how close Amy Chow is, 5 hundredths of a point. We've got quite a battle as we head down the stretch here at the RCA Gymnastics Challenge. Back to Las Vegas after this. Vegas, continuing our coverage of the Visa American Cup Series here in the RCA Gymnastics Challenge. The women have reached the halfway mark. Amy Chow leads the way, then it's Tasha Schweikert back by a few tenths. But if Tasha could somehow beat Morgan White, that would be a big step for her. All of this comes under the watchful eye of the new national team coordinator. And I want to tell you, Bella Crowley was working the room today, talking to virtually anybody who has anything to do with USA Gymnastics. But back he is. And where he goes, there's usually a little controversy involved. Tim Daggett sat down and talked to him today.
I know the time is short. It's extremely short. And every day we're getting closer and closer to the final stage. But I believe with the planning, how I was planning to have every single month a training camp, a centralized training camp, when the most important key people of the national team would come together to train together, to be, have an ability. I have an opportunity to give them directions, to give them the fire, to give them the incentive to stick together and to go strongly toward the final goal might make a major difference. I believe on the power and the talent of these young people, even though people are saying our depthness is not like we used to have, but I still know that physical talent is in there, but the desire gotta be upgraded and just the willingness to put everything in the line to reach our common goal. China was actually the second letdown of the team, coming up from the reigning Olympic world champion team title, going on to the sixth place in the world, is not the one what we deserve, not the one what these young, very talented athletes are deserving period. What I learned just watching the tapes and watching through the television broadcast their performance, my realization, technically they were up to be among the foremost countries in the world, gymnastic countries in the world, but physically they were not in shape. The physical readiness was way, way below the expectation. That's why they could not keep up with the everyday demand of performing right, being ready, being upbeat and be energetic on the floor. Yes, physical standards are the ones I'm concerned more about that, and upgrading that one is my major concern. Second of all, the fire, the unity. I mean, the fire in their eyes, the willingness to come out. But you know what? With the physical standard upgrading to the point, the confidence gonna come back, the smile gonna be there, that fiery desire to come out on the floor and to perform will come with them. So better preparation, more consistency on the preparation, and a more thorough preparation gonna give them the fire, and it will be easy to influence them positively. Come on the floor, let's go out over there and repeat the performances what we are entitled to have, and you deserve to have it.
Well, I tell you, it is impossible to be in a room with Bella Caroli and not be excited. He's going to bring that fire back. He's going to get him conditioned. But the most critical thing that he has to do, he needs for the coaches and the athletes to buy into this. If that happens, then it's a win-win for everyone.
Now Jay Thorne just trying to salvage what has been a very tough day. 9.025, 9.15, 8.85, 9.137.
There's another mistake. He's going to cover, and he's not going to get deductions for it, but he's going to lose a lot of bonus because of it. Great dismount, though. Beautiful double pike.
That psychs him up.
You know, Jay really can look good. Nice gymnast, very, very controlled in his work, but sometimes he has had some problems in international meets. Right there, he had to improvise, but he's been around. Didn't drop the ball completely.
And if you want to know what he thinks about this day, he and Stephen McCain, right from a gymnast standpoint, at American-Gymnast.com. So that's where you would get their perspective.
Tasha Schleicher
from Las Vegas on the balance beam. Huge support for her here. Now, who knows how this works out? Maybe Tasha Schleicher has an unbelievable year 2000, qualifies for the Olympic team. It'd be a great story. And one of the reasons why it would be so interesting is that she was actually born 2 months premature, meaning that she turns 16 in the Olympic calendar year. Had she been born on time, that would not have been the case. So that's a little quirk in making her eligible to go to Sydney.
Well, she is off to a tremendous start. I've been so impressed with how serious she has treated this competition. And we are finding out right now a little bit more of how she handles great pressure at an international event. Coming up to a big pass here. Solid.
Doesn't hurt that she's got the big home gym advantage. Those big cheers pump you up.
Sometimes that can throw you off, but this is really helping her out.
And if there's a place where the nerves can come into play, it's balance beam.
Just remember, if the Ukrainians had their visa, she's watching this on television. Or maybe just sitting in street clothes up in the stands.
Just the dismount. Oh, that's a shame.
That's too bad, because that dismount had plenty of power.
Mom Joy and Dad Shannon Warren, she trailed Amy Chow by 4/10 coming in, and you see the disappointment on her face. She's so close to sticking that pulling that off.
Let up just a little bit too early, and like Tim mentioned, that is a breeze for her. She has so much power. Look at way up there. Just a little bit longer, she would have been there. That's a shame, although that is a deduction, probably up to 3/10.
Yeah, you think about those for a long, long time, I'll tell you.
Mom and Dad watching the dismount. There it comes.
Darn.
Darn it.
Ouch. Too bad.
Now, but they've announced Jay Thornton's score. It's a 9.325. That's significant because it's the best score he's had all day, and it moves him ahead of fellow American Stephen McCain. Now we go back to the P-bars, and Brett McClure has everything prepped just the way he likes it. Remember, like Tasha Schweikert, as this thing goes along and you start realizing what's possible for you today, you could go one of two ways. You can be energized by it, or you can be just trapped by it.
We'll see what he's made of right here.
And right here, very difficult. Giant to double back. You know what's amazing is he's been a little bit off, but you don't see the knees bending or form breaking. He's keeping his composure. He really has a very nice look about him when he does gymnastics.
Oh.
Oh, boy. That's too bad.
Isn't it interesting that our two last-minute additions both stumbled on the dismount within 30 seconds of each other?
That routine was, it was on the edge from start to finish. He was just a little bit behind everywhere. Holds on to this pike too long. And that sit down, that's 5/10 of a point. He's still in the race, though.
Whew. One more.
Tasha Schweikert, and she takes a big hit, an 8.8. That will knock her down a bit, and now she's got to worry about Morgan White behind. Meanwhile, as soon as this competition is over, everybody heads to Bella Caroli's 1,200-acre ranch outside Houston for the first of his monthly camps. And the Bella effect for the Olympics in 2000 will begin to be felt. We welcome you back to the MGM Grand Arena as the RCA Gymnastics Challenge continues here in Las Vegas. Bella Caroli is not the only 96 comeback story that we're covering during these championships. Log on to NBCOlympics.com to follow our ongoing coverage of Amy Chow and Dominique Mociano as they prepare for their ultimate test in Sydney. That's all at NBCOlympics.com. The score is in for Brett McClure, and it's his worst of the day. 8.762. That means that his lead right now over Jay Thornton to be the number one American here today, that's significant in this Visa American Cup Series, is down to 5/10. He is really going to feel it in the final rotation for the men. Now to the beam, continuing with the women, Alona Poloshkova of Belarus.
What you're seeing a lot from the ladies today are mounts into connections such as what she just performed, a little beat jump. That is giving her some valuable bonus points. We talked about her elegant lines, and that's obvious. This team has a lot of ballet training, and this is one event where it really shines through.
Amy Chow held a slim lead over Alona Poloshkova. After the second rotation, she will be the last woman to record a number here in this rotation. Amy Chow, that is.
Ilona spoke wonderful English, provided us with all the information. She said that both the juniors and seniors train together. There are 12 of them in Minsk, which is their national training center. Take a look at this skill.
By the way, it's not easy to get from Belarus to Las Vegas. They were saying it was an 18-hour journey.
This is experience showing through. She has been a veteran of this team. final skill, her dismount. Taking a little bit extra time here.
Nice pike position in the air, though.
Great exercise.
She's putting the pressure on. She's already recorded one of the highest scores of the day. Yeah, Bella Caroli nods in agreement. That was good, what we just watched.
Yeah, 20 years old, believe it or not. One of the top athletes for this team. This is the skill I was speaking of, the front summy into the beat jump, a connection which is valuable because she gets bonus points. Interesting combination here, the back handspring into the full twisting swing down. You have to be so square to that 4-inch balance beam.
Alona Poloshkova's score now is a 9.475. That's going to put the pressure on now Amy Chow and Elena Prodanova, because Prodanova's lead over Amy Chow was 0.05 of a point, and over Poloshkova, 0.12 of a point. So this is coming down to the final rotation, and looking like it's going to be a matter of tenths and hundredths. And now it is Elena Prodanova on the beam.
Take a look at this mount. We talked about the connections. This is really a pretty combination. Front salto into a Shushanova.
Little bit long there.
A little bit of a pause, which means she might not get that 10th connection.
She's so aggressive, though, in all of her gymnastics.
You know, we talk about reputation. She's the type of gymnast that just looks like she knows what she's doing before she even does anything. That was nice.
So aggressive. Just explodes off the balance beam. No question that that wolf jump was in perfect position.
Talked about her originality on vaulting, and she doesn't always take the most traditional route.
Pretty skill right here, Kim.
Very
it's called
nice.
An Anodi. Again, connecting it into a jump. That's what we're seeing the women do throughout their balance beam routines. It's all about connections today.
Here comes what we were talking about, just finding a different way to do something. Getting some of those bonus points. Double front somersault, very difficult. And also what we call a blind landing. Can't see the floor.
Oh, wow. Too much rotation.
Well, we know she'll be in Sydney, and we know she'll be a factor. The flaming red hair, trying to win this RCA Gymnastics Challenge.
This was the only event she didn't participate in the event finals on at the World Championships. Look at that, two revolutions, had too much oomph, and has to take a huge step on the landing. But a reminder, that is a tough dismount.
Two more Americans to come on the balance beam, and then we'll see if there's a challenge to Elena Prodanova's lead. Morgan White, Amy Chow, still to come in Las Vegas. Back in Las Vegas, you're looking at the face of Morgan White about to mount the balance beam. She started with a struggle, but has been coming back since. The score for Elena Prodanova is a 9.375. She has reclaimed the lead, but she has only a 0.025 of a point advantage over Alona Poloshkova of Belarus with one rotation to go. Tight stuff.
Well, you know, Morgan had mentioned to us how nervous she was for this competition. She said she really needs to get back into the mode of competing. She almost forgets what it's like to be out there in the international field. On this event, she needs to think what she told us is one skill at a time.
And she also said, straight down the beam. I would say that's pretty good thoughts.
Tough mentally in an event like this with the rotations the way they are. It's a long time between routines.
There's that popular mount that we've been seeing from many of the women. Getting set for a very difficult combination. The second element has one of the highest degrees of difficulty. It's an E element called an Anodi. We've already seen Prodanova perform the skill.
This one done in combination, much more difficult. Very nice, but that small balance check will cost her a little bit.
Thank you. Morgan's actually changed her choreography around a little bit since the World Championship, struggled somewhat at the Worlds on the balance beam, came back home and decided to change things around so she'd feel more comfortable. We saw the Onodi, that's an E element. Here's an example of a D element.
Punch front, a little bit under rotated on that, landed a little low.
Just her dismount, planning a 2.5 twist. Big hop.
Little nick here, little nick there.
Yeah, she stayed on, that's the important thing.
It's amazing how those can add up, though, those little tidbits here and there.
It, you know, like I can feel it because you're a lot more fidgety than you usually are.
Sorry, it's the beginning of the season. That's probably why.
I don't know if she can catch Amy Chow, and I'm not sure now whether she can catch Tasha Schweikert, but certainly she would love to do that here today.
Trying to stay straight down the line. There's the back handspring into the Onodi. A half turn in the air, blind landing. You could see just a little problem right there. Very tough element, again, an E element. It's worth 2/10.
We throw out these names all the time. That Onodi, named after a great Hungarian gymnast.
Put yourself under the gun a little bit more so it feels like
Mary Lee
that.
Tracy constantly coaches.
A little more, your body language is a little more calm than what I've seen today.
She has a huge group of athletes training down in Cincinnati Gymnastics right now. And her newest addition to the Cincinnati stable, Dominique Mocianu, now a teammate of Morgan White.
Over to parallel bars we go. Eric Lopez of Cuba, big time comeback for him.
Like we've said over and over again, very strong gymnast. It's all about connecting difficult elements like that giant double back together. He does it 2 times in his exercise. Your arms really take a pounding on parallel bars nowadays. Just the dismount. Big step on that landing, but he'll take that one.
And now we get the score for Morgan White.
9.4.
A 9.4. She'll take that.
Yes, I know what it is.
And that puts the pressure on Tasha Schweikert from behind heading into the last rotation. Laura Martinez.
Great start to the competition with the vault, but had a disastrous fall on her landing. So that's the last thing that she remembers. Horrible dismount on the uneven bars. Really has to get down and focus on this event.
Very nice, going the other way. We've seen a bunch of front flips there. Ground out, back layout, step out, perfectly on.
That's refreshing.
It's an important routine for her coming into this third rotation. She was the number 3 international gymnast. She's right on the bubble.
She'll do 3 tumbling skills in sequence. Flip-flop, layout into flip-flop. It's a pretty element right here. They have a rhythmic gymnast from Spain that helps in all the choreography, both on the balance beam and the floor exercise. Jesus Carballo said that the team he fielded at the World Championships in Tianjin was the best team he has ever put out on the World Championship floor. In fact, all the kids, all his athletes were rookies. There wasn't one athlete that had ever competed at a Worlds before. That's pretty remarkable when you consider they finished 7th.
And I'll tell you, they really, in a lot of ways, I thought they didn't get their due in China. They ended up 7th.
Very tough element she just completed there. Again, a popular move. It's called a wolf jump. She did it with a full twist. It's an E element. She gets through this one.
Trying to hold on to that final spot. And now the tally for Eric Lopez, it's a 9.4. He moves ahead of Brett McClure. So this has been a big charge up the leaderboard for Eric Lopez. He started slowly, then was fourth, then was third, now is second, depending on how Alexei Bondarenko does. And for Alexei Bondarenko, a trip to Las Vegas reunites him with a good old friend, Vitaly Sherbo, the most decorated male Olympic gymnast ever. This was yesterday. He has a gymnastic school here in Las Vegas, and it looks as though his new life is fulfilling in every way.
Yeah.
But he's a popular guy.
Yeah, yeah, a great guy, and just tremendous, tremendous gymnast. He will be remembered forever in the sport. Six Olympic gold medals in one games. He is just unbelievable.
Remember, Bondarenko had the lead. Eric Lopez of Cuba has had four straight big-time routines. We'll see if Bondarenko can hold on to the number one spot.
Well, he's the current silver medalist in the world on this event, and deservedly so. Nothing stops here. He just keeps moving. Beautiful element. Watch this. Very difficult. Makes it look so easy. Small step there in that handstand. But this is going to keep him comfortably in the lead.
Alexei Bondarenko so far today in Las Vegas, the class of the field. But off that, it looks like it's going to be Bondarenko, Lopez, and the surprising American, Brett McClure.
The great thing about this exercise, everything keeps moving. Watch this. He'll jump off his arms, do a three-quarter twist, and land in a handstand. Very unconventional and a lot harder than it looks, actually.
9.5. 9.5, a big score for Laura Martinez. Once again, across the floor here at the MGM Grand Garden in Las Vegas, Amy Chow, the last woman to go on the balance beam.
What's interesting about Amy's routine right off the start, it's a very simple mount. She chooses to get on very simply, but the rest of this routine is packed with difficulty starting right here.
I've been watching gymnastics for a lot of years, and every time I see a female gymnast do a backflip with a full twist, like this right here.
Oh.
Oh, God. That's too bad.
That's a hard skill.
Boy, there's a lot going on there.
Every time you fall, of course, 5/10 deduction, automatic. We do tend to see a few more of those full twisting back somersaults in the world, but very few done in the pike position like Amy just attempted.
Another very difficult combination, ending with a full twist swing down. She said her decision to come back to the international scene was not based at all on U.S. results. She's watched the competition. She watched the world championship. She just said simply, I want to come back. There's something more for me.
Big dismount, triple twist.
In combination.
Oh, that was great.
Yeah, it's the hardest dismount along with Kudinova's.
But guess what? That 5/10 deduction could be a huge opportunity for Tasha Schweikert. Just when it looked like Amy Chow was going to cruise in this event, she doesn't.
Well, you take the risk, you know. You got to do it to get the big score.
Huge this element.
So hard. And you see the shoulders just
a
little bit.
Yeah, she was on. Hips were squared to the beam. The shoulders were off. That's what threw her off the beam.
So while Amy Chow smiles through it, we go back to the men's story for a moment. For Alexei Bondarenko has a score of 9.437, and he's got a huge lead over Eric Lopez of Cuba. He'd almost have to not show up for the sixth rotation to miss this. It's a lead of 0.688. heading to the high bar. The score for Amy Chow is a tough one for her to swallow, I'm sure. It's an 8.375, and everything has gone topsy-turvy in the American women's battle here. I had said it was a big opportunity for Tasha Schweikert. I was wrong. It turns out to be a big chance now for Morgan White, who suddenly is the top American looking at an American Cup with one rotation to go. Then it's Tasha Schweikert, and Amy Chow has fallen from the first American to the third. Elena Prudenova still leads. And let's take you over to the men's story. After five rotations, it's Alexei Bondarenko, Eric Lopez of Cuba coming on, but he trails by a ton. Then the most important thing is, who's it going to be as the top American? Right now, it's Brett McClure. We'll see as we head to the final rotation here in Las Vegas next.
That's what wasn't there before that's there now, all right? Okay. Breathe. Just another floor routine that's going to be better and stronger than ever.
We're back at the RCA Gymnastics Challenge, and everything's all changed now in the women's story, especially on the American side. Here, let's go to Beth Rujak. Beth?
Well, Al, this is the moment that has opportunity written all over it for Morgan White. If she had some nerves at the beginning of the meet, which is what everyone on the sidelines is saying she had, she's been able to kick them out of the way. And I just checked in with Mary Lee Tracy, and I said, what do you say to her right now at a moment like this? And she said, you just tell her to fight. You just tell her to go for it. And everyone here thinks she can do it.
They're turning a rough start into a good finish. We go to the final rotation first for the men, and that means the high bar, of course. And Jay Thornton was certainly energized by the last score he put up. And we'll see how he can cap his day. The first four rotations were not something he'll want to cherish.
And this is a big routine for Jay. A lot going on. A couple of new elements in his exercise as well. One of them comes right off the top. Saw this earlier from Amy Chow. Endo in an L grip position, very difficult. When they pick up speed like that, that means Kovacs way up in the air. Much of high bar is, can you do things in combination? Jay does that very well. Bunch of elements done in a row. Dismount. Full twisting double layout. Big step on that landing.
Jay Thornton is not going to catch Brett McClure, who had a huge lead. And that's the surprising thing. Thornton and Stephen McCain were part of the world championship team, although Thornton was an alternate. Brett McClure wasn't even on the world championship team. And here he is making a major statement about where he all fits right, into this time. American team right now. Who knows? He may be headed to the American Cup, depending on how this all works out. Across the floor to Tasha Schweikert. From right here in Las Vegas, this day started out so promising. For a while, she was the number one American. Amy Chow was then able to take over the top spot, but Amy Chow's bad fall has allowed Morgan White to grab the top American position.
It's just been going back and forth, but let me tell you, for Tasha, this is a great event. She is known for her power. However, her opening tumbling pass, a little bit scary in the warm-up. I haven't seen her perform one on her own.
And this is very interesting here. The coach actually thought that they were allowed to use what's called a sting mat in gymnastics, and she went out there to pull it in. Cassie, right there. And she was told by the head judge that it's not allowed in this competition. Bit of a controversy.
Eye contact with the coach.
So here comes that first tumbling run.
Big skill for her. Oh, she piped it down.
Out of bounds.
Yeah, that's a tenth. Out of bounds is 1/10.
Very nice.
Oh,
huge dismount plant, a triple twist.
I tell you, all in all, this young lady has to be very, very pleased and proud of what she did at this competition today.
Coming in last minute, said she was using this for experience. She got so much more out of it. However, this was a shame. I think it must have rattled her a little bit when she wasn't able to use the sting mat, concerned about the landing. Instead of doing a double layout, she piked her body in, changing the element altogether and losing valuable bonus points.
And also taking that step out of bounds, that'll cost her as well.
It seemed like it really bothered her when they took the mat away, and now the score for Thornton is a 9.362, so he wraps it up with a smile. And all Brett McClure needs to beat Thornton and be the top American today is an 8.9 and change. Obviously, that's very, very doable, so keep that in mind. 8.914 to be exact, and he is the number one American, a last-minute addition.
Coda points on high bar was written for Brett McClure. Very flexible. These inside Stalter elements bring in huge bonus points. He also doesn't need to do a very difficult release because he's able to get it through combinations like this. One-arm giant right into that element right there. Gives him 5/10 of bonus. Release right here. Because he's so good, he can do an easy release like that. All he's got to do is land on his feet, and it is no problem. Brett McClure, oh! Unbelievable. Well, now that just made it very, very interesting.
You mean score-wise?
Oh, yeah. I mean, that dismount right there was, it's a minimum 5/10 deduction for sitting down, and then he also piked his body dramatically in the air. You'll see his body supposed to remain completely laid out. That gives him an extra 10th of a point. He has to pike down into the ground.
What happened there?
I don't know. That was pretty creepy. That's not good. This is going to be very close now. Very close.
It's going to be a nervous wait now for Brett McClure. This looked like one of those days where maybe you refocus and turn your career around and get it headed in a totally different direction. Tasha Schweikert's score is a 9.20. And guys, I don't believe it, but Brett McClure did not do it. He needed an 8.914. It sounded so easy for him. He gets an 8.775, and Jay Thornton, who started this day as unsteady as you can be, is now the top American. When we come back, Morgan White has one more thing to do, and her destiny is floor exercise next.
This woman is all about power. She explodes in this tumbling pass. Her first tumbling pass is one of the most difficult and exciting that you'll see in the world.
Yeah, it's not that she just does something hard. It's watch the way she does it.
She needs a 9.376 to stay ahead of the gymnast from Belarus. See the way she blew her hair out of her face in the middle of the whole thing?
She's cool.
Here we go again.
Wow.
Yikes, that's hard.
Blind landings.
Well, she's found something a little bit different, a little unusual, that's also very difficult, and she does it extremely well.
First two tumbling passes were breeze, this one should be just as easy for her.
Yeah, I would say that should do it, no problem at all. I'll tell you, if I was a coach, I would want her on my team, no question about that.
She is a team player. This was an absolutely outstanding tumbling pass, an Arabian double front, but what makes it so difficult, there's the double front, is she rebounds into a punch front.
She was actually a little bit off on that, but no problem. When you got legs like that, you can jump anyway.
And now we go back to the men on the high bar. We're going to focus in here on a man who sort of created a little story for himself. And our first look, Jorge Giraldo of Colombia. He and Zoltán Csupala of Hungary have, well, they've been locked up in a tight battle for the third and final international gymnast spot, which gets them into the American Cup.
And I tell you, this is probably the most pressure he's ever been under to hit this high bar routine. Very, very nice combination here. His feet on the bar on that one element's gonna cost him a little bit though. It's gonna be a judgment call whether they give him that element. Double twisting, double somersault, and he threw it out there. That's for sure.
He had a 3.5-tenth lead over the Hungarian coming into this final rotation.
Well, I'll tell you, it's gonna be very, very interesting because there's one skill in the exercise that if they decide to give it to him, it changes his start value by a whole bunch of points. And could go either way.
Now the score that Elena Prudinova needed to go to the top here at the RCA Gymnastics Challenge was a 9.376. She has to be better than that, and she is, a 9.6 for Elena Prudinova. And that just about locks up a big payday and a trip to Disney World. And now it's Morgan White. What does she do with this opportunity that was created by the fall of Amy Chow? She was the last American. Now she's the first American into this last floor exercise.
A couple key things that Morgan thinks of before her exercise is to keep a tight body and to just go out there and have fun. Brand new routine.
Ending
a triple twist.
Didn't quite get that one around. That's gonna hurt a little bit.
You know, the little nick here, the little nick there is one thing, but when you have those major breaks,
they all add up. You know, she says she needs to have fun in order to do the best job possible, and you could see the concentration on her face throughout the entire routine.
That second pass though is a major fall. Nowhere near enough rotation. Put her hand back and pretty much sat down. Very, very tricky and intricate tumbling pass. Whip with a half turn into a double twist.
Not enough height.
Yeah, nowhere near enough bounce on that. And not a good effort.
What's it going to be? Which American is going to claim the top spot here? We'll get Morgan White's score in a moment. We welcome you back to the MGM Grand Arena as the RCA Gymnastics Challenge continues here in Las Vegas. Now, Morgan White's tally.
What's it going to be? 9.025.
Now, she doesn't have a calculator in her head. She's not quite sure how to take that. And the reason is, it's going to force Amy Chow to be pretty darn good. She needs a 9.413 to take the lead away from Morgan White. And the score for Geraldo of Colombia was a 9.387. And now we go to Eric Lopez of Cuba. Cuba's heading to the Olympics. He looks like he's going, and he also looks like he's going to the American Cup.
Finished last year fifth in the American Cup.
And I certainly don't want to jinx this young man, but he, last time I saw him on high bar, it wasn't pretty at the World Championships. It can happen on this event. 6.95.
That was a bad day.
That's exactly what he said. Very, look at that. Tricky element. Watch this right here. Release skill, no problem today. Well, we said this before, just the dismount. And he's going, well, he'll be there.
We're still awaiting the big last performance of Amy Chow on floor exercise, but not yet. Laura Martinez of Spain first.
She says that floor exercise is her best and her favorite event. She likes the mix of athleticism, the dance, and the choreography all into one package. To do the forward twisting nowadays to get the big scores with the bonus, but she's at least able to add a full twisting double somersault. Very refreshing to see that.
Which apparatus do you guys think is the toughest to get your start value to a 10?
Well, in a lot of ways, balance beam is the easiest, but also the hardest because, oh, beautiful, beautiful triple fall at the end.
Came back very strong. The last half of her competition, you know, she'd love to be able to do that uneven bar set all over again.
Yeah, I tell you, but I was really glad to see her have no problem with the tumbling there, taking that fall on bars. You're always wondering if the ankles and the knees are okay, but she looks like she's fine. And a beautiful exercise.
Well, again, credit to Jesus Carballo Sr. What he has done with this Spanish team is they are in top condition, both physically, mentally. He says that this young athlete is one of his most talented on the team. Beautiful triple full.
And with this performance today, Laura Martinez looks like she's wrapping up a trip to the American Cup. And Eric Lopez's day is done here in Las Vegas. He gets a 9.162. And that should really pave the way for an easy win for Alexei Bondarenko. But the way things have gone on the women's side of this, we're not so sure. But Bondarenko only needs now, as we crunch the numbers, an 8.475 to win and complete what looks like a Russian sweep here in Nevada. Elena Prudinova has clinched it. Nobody can catch her on the women's side. She has won this RCA Gymnastics Challenge. And now with Arkayev, the legendary Russian coach, assisting, Bondarenko makes his last mount of the day.
And this should be really exciting. Big element coming up right here. Had trouble in warm-ups. Way in the air. Hike Kovacs will do another one. This one tucked. A little bit close to the bar. A lot of experience, though. Able to deal with that. As we've said over and over again, this young man, a contender. And a number of events, high bar being one of them, and the all-around for some gold in Sydney. Oh, unbelievable. You know that? Looked like he was worried about landing on the mat. Had an extra crash pad there and was gonna land right in the crack and kind of scooted his feet so he would miss it. That's incredible. Here's the dismount here, very difficult, double twisting, double somersault, and right as his feet are supposed to go down, that mat that you see really shouldn't be there. He ends up scooting his feet, like I said. I think that caused him to sit that down. Wow.
Well, it's Elena Protonova, Ilona Poliskova of Belarus, and Laura Martinez headed to the American Cup with a score of a 9.50. Her day is complete. So there you have the top three international gymnasts. And now it's Amy Chow. Amy needs a 9.413. And today, that's a very good score.
Very doable for Amy Chow. What she needs to do is just stand up.
Big mount, whipped through a piped, full twisting double somersault.
Yeah, in warm-up, this is what she had a problem with.
Not there.
That's it. She got through it.
That's it.
It would have been such a nice Amy Chow returns to gymnastics story. Now it looks like the story is Morgan White takes a step forward. Battle this has been to watch here today between these two. They've all shared a little misfortune.
This wasn't meant to be this time around, huh? Okay. This is just the start, right?
So finally we got to start. We finally got to start.
A little bit of rust there. We'll work it out, right?
When we come back to Las Vegas, who's in, who's out in a moment.
NBC Sports World is brought to you by RCA, changing entertainment again. By the Grand Am with solid form design, its excitement well built from Pontiac.
Well, it was a $5,000 tenth of a point in favor of Alexei Bondarenko. Remember how he fell on his dismount moments ago off the high bar, and we said he had such a huge cushion? Well, the judges hit him, and they hit him hard. He got an 8.575, and he wins this RCA Gymnastics Challenge by 1/10 and 1/1000. Amy Chow needed a 9.413 to overtake Morgan White, whose day started with an 8.6. And Amy Chow has been given an 8.725. And so the number one American finisher here today, boy, after the first rotation, who would have thought that was possible? But it's Morgan White. She is on her way to the American Cup. So here's the story. First for the women, Elena Protonova has a very productive day. Meanwhile, Morgan White is also going as the top American finisher today. But boy, what a surprise compared to the way this day got started. She's with Beth Rujak and Coach Mary Lee Tracy.
Well, Morgan, it was a day that everybody seemed to have a chance to grab, and you started almost as low as anybody could have. And at the end, here you are. Congratulations on winning today.
Thank you. It's been a weird day. I'm tremendously excited that I made it to the American Cup. You know, I'm disappointed, and I don't like to make it somewhere by falling and by not doing the best I could do, but I still made it, and I'm really happy about that. And I'm just going to go back to the gym and work harder and try to fix the things that, you know, that I had problems with and the mental blocks that I had, and just try to fix them so that I can go to American Cup and do a lot better.
And now the story for the men. Alexei Bondarenko claims the win, but barely. Remember that last dismount off the high bar? Eric Lopez of Cuba and Jay Thornton of the United States wrap up the top three. Now Thornton has a chance, depending on how this number that he put up today stands in a few weeks, February 5th here on NBC in the second competition in St. Petersburg of this Visa American Cup Series. But at least for now, he's in the running to go to the American Cup, and he's with Beth Rujak.
Jay, I know you were sitting over there at the beginning of that last rotation thinking this meet was not yours, and here it is.
Yeah, the very beginning of the meet, started off a little rough on floor and pommel horse, made it through. Then rings was kind of my worst event of the competition, so I was a little worried after that I wasn't going to be anywhere close to the top. And then thing just kept plugging away and hit a great set on P-bars and a great set on high bar, and ended up in third place, I guess. And so, yeah, I'm delighted.
So now you go back to the training center in this Olympic year, and you've learned what? What do you add into the mix as everybody looks ahead to this team that's going to go to Sydney?
The biggest thing I learned is it comes down to the last event. The meet's not over until the last man dismounts, and I think I just have to make sure that during any competition, I make sure that I'm working towards the Olympic team and making sure I take everything seriously, and that I know that everything counts towards making that Olympic team, the competition and training and everything, and just can't give up until the very end.
All right, Beth. Up next on NBC, stay tuned for the Gateway Freestyle Millennium Challenge. And for more on Olympic gymnastics, including additional analysis from Tim and Elfie, log on to NBCOlympics.com. We certainly hope you have enjoyed the RCA Gymnastics Challenge. For Tim Daggett, Elfie Schlegel, and Beth Rujak, I'm Al Troutwig. We'll see you next time. Ahmad Rashad is in our New York studios after this on NBC.